Welcome to this week's Weekly Update, where we here at IdahoReporter.com get you caught up on the important issues happening around the state. We start this week with some urban renewal news in Boise. Boise's Urban Renewal Agency, the Capital City Development Corporation, or CCDC, has approved national grocery chain Whole Foods and Oregon brewery 10 Barrel Brewing for hundreds of thousands of dollars in grant funding from Tax Increment Financing, TIF, to redevelop streetscapes and sidewalks surrounding their forthcoming businesses in downtown Boise. Whole Foods will receive $300,000, while 10 Barrel Brewing will receive around $75,000. You may recall 10 Barrel is already a beneficiary of a lease agreement with the Idaho Department of Lands, though its project may be in some trouble. The company is having trouble getting a license to run an Idaho-based retail brewery while also holding an alcohol beverage control certificate allowing it to import beer from outside the state. Idaho law does not allow an out-of-state company to sell alcohol at its Idaho establishment while licensed as an importer. Personal property tax has been a hot topic during recent legislative sessions, with one side arguing that it's a bad tax and it should be repealed, and the other side saying it would be too devastating to local governments, estimating a $135 million loss in revenue for the counties. Alex LeBeau, president of the Idaho Association of Commerce and Industry, which is in favor of the repeal, said his organization has been working with the counties for 5 years and they refuse to compromise. LeBeau says because of this unwillingness from the counties, the time has come to move a bill to repeal the tax. House Majority Leader Mike Moyle believes the repeal has a better chance of getting through the legislature this session than in the past, and he's in favor of the repeal. Both LeBeau and Moyle say it's simply a bad tax. On Monday, August 20th, Senator Mike Crapo held a public meeting at the state capitol to discuss the fiscal cliff our nation faces. Joining him on the panel was Senator Jim Risch, Representative Raul Labrador, Lieutenant Governor Brad Little, and Maya McGinnis, President of the Committee for a Responsible Budget. All four said something in Washington has to change because the current direction we are going is not sustainable. Crapo said he believes, as far as internal threats go, quote, there is no greater threat that we have ever faced, end quote. He also said the status quo obviously isn't working.
The worst option of all is the status quo. The worst thing that we could do as a nation is to not deal with the problem. Because if we don't, then the bond markets will. And the day that that happens, then the problem will become much worse. The disaster in the United States economically will become much deeper. The time that it will take to build out of it will be extended significantly. And the opportunities that we talk about that we could take here will be significantly reduced.
Representative Labrador was also quick to point out that although he has taken some heat from the media and some of his colleagues, he believes that, without doubt, everything needs to be on the table for cuts.
I say that everything has to be on the table, and we need to stop picking winners and losers in Washington, D.C. We need to stop doing the things that we protect our states at the expense of every other state, that we protect our districts at the expense of every other district. And I've taken some pretty tough votes in Washington because I think everything needs to be cut and everything needs to be put on the table.
Stay up to date by visiting our website, liking us on Facebook, or following us on Twitter. That wraps up this week's Weekly Update. Thank you for watching.